Welcome to Krim's Crib.
Yo, welcome to Krim's Crib, where it's not really my crib, but we don't change the name because it sounds cool, and we're really not at my crib. Today, we're on location at Blaze World Barbershop. Thanks, Blaze, that we get to be here. And we had to be here so we could link up with none other than these guys here, dog. Coast.
Yeah, what
my
do?
Favorite. GT.
What's good? What's
one of
goody?
My favorites. And Bunz. I haven't seen you in forever.
What's good to see you, sir. What's good, baby?
Man, y'all don't even remember. I remember when I was the DM in fucking Garza to come fuck with me on a show or come do something, some kind of conversation. This nigga wouldn't even read my shit. I said, I don't think that nigga even knows. I don't even think that nigga knows I'm Krim. Like, nigga, like your homeboy, nigga.
Yeah.
Like, nah, just keep it real. Like, I was like, he probably doesn't know.
That's the way to start a conversation.
Yeah, nigga, come on. We're here to talk cookies.
Why you read my message?
What up? Hey, no. I'm saying, fuck? I thought he probably thought, like, I'm not the same person. Like, I was like, maybe he doesn't know who I am. Like,
it was years later. That's like a decade later since the last time I seen him.
Well, yeah. So I figured, like, he's probably like, it's just some, who the fuck is this nigga, bro?
Nah, I done moved up already, man. Fuck all that shit. Nah.
But I didn't take it personally, but I figured you probably didn't know.
Nah, I got
right?
You.
You know what I'm saying? So, whatever. Anyways. But since the last time I did see y'all, man, shit. Bunz, the last time I seen you, you had long-ass hair.
Man, that was years ago.
That's what I'm saying, nigga. That's how long it's been.
Yeah, goddamn transfer unit to make you cut your shit off. You know what I mean? All the way down. So that's fucked up.
You had some nice braids.
I had them nice, too. I miss them, too, man. Let's not talk about it. You know what? I should have told you that before the interview. I'm real sensitive about my braids.
All right.
My bad.
Nigga. Hey, but you got a nice bald head, man. I like it.
PTSD.
All right, man. And then the last time I seen Garza was, shit, man, dog. I think we, during Muhammad Ali video shoot, remember we did that video?
Bro,
at
that's
the Kings
exactly
of the Clippers?
My point. What year is that?
Nigga, that was like, what is that? Like
20 years ago.
No, nigga. 10. Maybe 10.
And he want to be like, he ain't answer my DM.
But nah, nigga.
Hey,
if a nigga, dog, if you hit me up, I know who GT Garza is.
That boy hit me up with Instagram first open.
Yeah. Hey, but if you hit me up and it says GT Garza, I know who it is, nigga. I'm not going to be like, who is this?
Yeah.
I know GT Garza.
I got
you. Then popular and I'm not.
For sure.
So then, it's fine. You're popular, I'm not popular.
Nah.
Hey, no, it's cool.
But nah, that was like 2006 time. Yeah, that was around that era.
And Coast, the last time I saw Coast, he made me pay him $100 for a fucking feature. Remember that?
You got hustled.
You got hustled. Hey, but it was better. The way he did that, hey, dog.
Facts.
That nigga should sell cars.
No.
You know what I'm saying?
Salesman.
He missed his fucking calling. This nigga could have been selling whips all over Houston.
Shit,
you know what I'm saying?
We do be selling whips.
Yeah. But, you know, in a good way. You know what I'm saying? I'm just being silly. Yeah. But, you know, he reminded me a better way of what we could be doing with this song. And he was, yo, I couldn't say no. The nigga like, dog, come on,
come
man.
On, nah.
He had it. Dog, he made it better.
Yeah, no, check it out. So what I did, right, he asked me for a feature.
Yeah.
And I pre-recorded it at the crib. And then we met up at FM spot. So yeah. I was going to give him the vocals, and he was going to give me the money. So I show him. I said, all right, look, this is what you paid me for. And I showed him the, I don't know if I did an 8 or a 16. I don't remember what I did.
It was a 12. Yeah.
So I show him that, and he's like, yeah, I'm fucking with that. And I said, now wait.
Here it comes.
I brought this other version too. I had recorded like some other shit on top of the hook in the intro, in the bridge and shit like that. Like I laced it all up.
Yeah.
I said, so this one is what you paid me for, but if you got a little extra in your pocket, I'll sell you this one.
Yeah. And I couldn't say no, nigga. It sounded great.
From now on, I'm doing all my features like that.
Yes. Hey, take a page from...
You pay me for this, but you could get this, though.
This is what you asked for. This is what I did.
See, like, learn something new every day with Coach.
Man, Coach, but did you go in there like so confident? Like, I know he's going to take the other one.
Yeah.
That's good. What if he never crossed your mind? Like, what if he doesn't take this? Why am I doing all this work?
Nah, bro, all that comes easy to me.
Yeah.
You know
no, but you were never like, man, I did that for nothing if he doesn't buy it.
Nah, I wasn't.
Oh, he's a cheap ass nigga. You know what I'm saying? Like, you never once thought that way?
Nah. Like, even if you would have said, man, I only got this 20, well, let me not put myself out there like that because that's not going to happen a second time. But even if you would have said, man, I only got this $20 on me to throw
on. You would have been cool.
Yeah, I would have been cool about it.
But regardless, I always say that story when I tell people about Coast.
Yeah.
And not to be like on some shit, but like, you know, the nigga's talented. Like, you can't not.
Appreciate that.
You feel me? You know what I'm saying? And I've told you a million times, and I've said it about you with you not even in the room. Coast is the best rapper in Houston, man.
Thank you, bro.
I listen. I was just listening to the fucking Thinking Out Loud on the way over here, part two.
Mm, really?
Yeah. So, but anywho, dog, it's not. I get it's not all about you right now. It's about all of y'all.
Right.
But I do want to get. I do hope that we can get into a little bit about all of you separately as well, too, though. Not just about, you know, what y'all are doing now, which is right now, right? Y'all are promoting the album, the one that's coming out, right? Tell us more about that.
Definitely. So right now we got a single out right now called "Fuck with a Mexican." It's me, Coz Bunz. Check it out on youtube.com/GT Garza TV. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
I saw it today.
Yeah, man, we out here, you know, just, yeah. You know.
Share, repost it.
Yeah, repping for the people, man, you know what I'm saying? The voice of the voiceless.
Did y'all feel like you needed to make it that way, like, with a Mexican put that and, like, really push that?
Nah. Honest with you, that shit just happens organically.
Yeah.
We get in the studio, we just cook up all type of different music, styles, vibes. You know, he got a dope, like, R&B background as well as, like, a dope, you know, hip-hop background. Right. So you never know what we're going to make when we get in the studio.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So that just what came about, and then it was just a dope way for us to start pushing the album. You know what I'm saying?
Cause I mean, you know, I'm sure, you know, like I said, I know it's organic. I get that. But do you ever feel like you're still having that same battle, nigga, that we were having even when I was around back in the day? Like, you know, even Coast could probably even speak on it from even his beginning to now. It's like we still having that battle of trying to get Hispanics through this door. Like, is it still the same? I mean, I don't know. Cause I'm not really in the game. Eternal could speak on it too, I guess. I mean,
say that on our behalf. I would say because, you know, me, him, and Paul Wall just did a record. You know, I got many records with Slim Thug, Zero, Lil Kiki.
The one on your last record, the Coast was on it, that one?
Yeah, Mouthful of Rocks.
Tight.
Yeah,
that
bro.
That was tight.
That boy,
I like that one, dog, yeah.
Coast think he good, bro. Let me tell you.
I love that song. Yeah. Dog,
but like,
that was tight.
We connect with everybody in the city because, you know, that's what we want to do. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
The people that we grew up listening to.
Yeah.
You know, we want to be able to, you know, make records with them and then, you know, keep it moving and keep things growing and, you know, climb that ladder.
Yeah.
So
well, I mean, you know, there's a lot of dope-ass Mexicans and a lot of Hispanics and all that, but, like, it needs to get to the point eventually, right, where it's not, like, it has nothing to do with Hispanics and blacks, and it's just good artists, right? Hasn't that always been our dream?
We always pushing that. Like, for us, like, I can't tell you, I don't rap with him because he Mexican or him because he Mexican. I rap with him because they good, and I like rapping with them.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? They make me want to rap better and be a better MC. You know what I'm saying? They keep me on my toes. You know, they think they killing me in my verses, but they not. I'm killing these fools. Okay. You know what I'm saying? If y'all don't go get this album, Brown Bond the 3, the Trinity coming soon.
You'll never know.
Y'all got a release date for it?
We don't got a release date. I will say this. Coast Crash, definitely all of us on Fuck With A Mess. He really showed his ass on that record, and that's the type of shit we like. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, we like getting in the studio and just, you know, going ham, bro. It's fun when you get to make music with the people you enjoy making music with.
That is true. And y'all always been like, even from back then when we were around and doing our thing too or whatever. I hate to keep saying that because I know Eternal, you still do your thing. But like, when I say that, I mean like me, I don't know, Braze, right? Us, whatever. But like, so when we were around, it was like, I guess like Mexicans were like rapping a certain way, or we were always like a certain type of rap style, all that. But like y'all always stood out even then from everyone. Like we sounded like Houston Mexicans, but like GT Garza sounded like he had some East Coast in him. You always had a different sound, you know what I'm saying? And then Coast was like always like, he didn't sound like a fucking, like, all the shit he was doing was not, like, typical, I guess what I'm trying to say. Like, it was always different. Y'all were always hybrids, nigga, in the city.
What do you think that was, though, dude?
I don't know, but I'm saying, like, that's what always stood out to me was, like, these dudes are not like everybody else. These dudes are not, like, you know, because you know how it is that what you're around, you're going to sound like. But they were around all the people that were like us, but they didn't sound nothing like us. You know what I'm saying?
But that's what separates you.
Yeah. But, you know how it is whenever typically people get into the rap game, they sound so much like the people they're rapping with, around. But y'all were never like that. You could get any, even if you were on a South Park Mexican feature, you were always you. It was never like, I got to rap like, sound more like this to be on this. You were always the way you are. And that always stood out to us. Like, dude, this dude is fucking talented. Or even Garza. Garza was always fucking crazy. Like, man, that was the first time ever hearing about you, GT. It was back then when you used to fuck with the SWAT and shit like that.
Yeah.
You remember?
Yeah, for sure.
That's when I heard
it. First time I heard of GT too.
Yeah, you were with the SWAT, Rob yeah. G. Mm-hmm. Shit, man. Who was? Hey, damn, man.
245 Dolomite. Man, RIP to Dolomite. My partner, Fame City. SWAT. It's a bunch of us, bro. Gang.
I don't want to fuck it up because I don't want to say it. But he was Zilla? A good friend of mine too. No, Zilla was dope. But what was the Asian dude?
245.
Oh man, dude, I used to see him all the time because I used to get my hair cut at another barbershop, and they own the
bottom downstairs.
The food court. Yeah, I used to always see him. I would be walking in, Krim. And then we talking shit.
Man, he's a wild one, bro. That's my brother, man. That dude
was cool. Man, he was solid. Cool. If he liked you, he was cool.
Yeah, for sure.
You know what I'm saying? So you know that's when I knew about you back then, when you were fucking with these dudes. You obviously, you kept going and all that, but what happened with that? Like, what happened? Like, what did, what made you kind of, I mean, did something happen that y'all just kind of went y'all's own ways, or like, or did you just were like, I need to do my thing, or
musically, at the time, Rob was doing, he was going to Corpus and making like, you know, different style of like Spanish music, you know, definitely trying to find his lane and what he wanted to do. He still had to deal with Universal. Mm-hmm. So he was spending a lot of time over there. And, you know, Bunz was around me at the time, and we were still doing a lot of rap and hip-hop stuff.
Yeah, so
you know, him being away from, you know, out of town, trying to get his shit going, and we trying to get our shit going, mm-hmm. you know, we really just was like, you know what, for right now, we're just going to keep continuing, pushing what we got going, and, you know, we'll link up, you know, whenever we can link back up in the future.
Yeah.
And, you know, literally, dog, like, I want to say, last year, 2 years ago, I linked back up with Rob, and we got this label running.
Yeah.
And now we back here full circle.
So Rob G's, La Maquina is Rob G's too?
Yeah, we 50-50 partners.
Not just you?
Nah, we 50-50 partners with that.
Oh, wow.
We got Crystal Pop and a deal with Charles Chavez at Latium, mm-hmm. a 50-50 partnership.
Yeah.
So this is us. You know,
right.
It's me,
and Bunz. So Bunz been around you since? Back in the gap. Y'all went to school together, or how do y'all know each other?
We didn't go to school together. We rapped in the closet together, though. You know what I mean? That's how far we go back. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, we ain't had nothing.
We ain't had shit, but... I knew him since about like 06.
Yeah.
Maybe 05, 06.
We used to drop like a lot of freestyles together, a lot of like, you know, download beats online and shit like that and just rap on them type
on
of shit.
Everybody shits. Else's shit.
Yeah. You met him through Rob G?
No. Or, I met him just
he met me through Hayden.
Like, yeah, really? We're going to tell this story, okay? Check this out. I tell this all the time. The same time you're talking about 52 pickup.
Yeah.
In my hood, I was the most popular Mexican, Richmond and Rosenberg at the time.
Okay.
So I walk into this female's room. She got a poster on the wall. Say Maverick Music on that bitch.
I remember Maverick. Damn, you glad you said that. I remember Maverick Music.
So I was pissed off.
Yeah.
I was like, man, fuck this nigga. You know what I mean? I thought I was the hottest little Mexican. Now she got another Mexican on it. So I started doing a whole bunch of like open mics in Houston.
Yeah.
When I was doing well at open mics, and mm-hmm. I just so happened to rap. While the SWAT, before the SWAT rap, you know what I mean?
Like at a show,
at a show, yeah, oh, like yeah, at a little yeah. show. And then we end up linking up like that.
Yeah.
And then I end up going to, what was that studio Chewy used to own back in the gap?
Bad Habits.
And then we really got linked up tough.
Did you know that
then.
Was him, though? That's the guy from the poster?
Yeah, I knew it was him. I tried to go hard that night. I went super hard, yeah. I knew it was him. But no, me and Carl's have been cool since day one. You know what I mean? When we met up, it was all love. And then we recorded at Bad Habits a lot.
Yeah,
and just started vibing, and
that's where it started.
Went to Sticky Greens, and been rapping ever since.
What were you working on around that time? That was like a title that we might know, like we'll hear.
I want to say Maverick Music 1, Maverick Music 1.5, which 52 Pickup came off of. I did Maverick Music 2. Man, we had a bunch of small mixtapes with me.
I remember when I had the record store inside the Kings of the Clippers.
Yeah,
I remember you dropped off the Batteries Not Included.
I had Batteries Not Included one.
I know you're doing them now, right? You're still doing them.
I like that one.
Me, Bunz, Fellow, we was all
just... Yeah, you were always on them, too.
We was all just coming up, you know what I'm saying?
Is that like an older... Now, looking back, that's like you had a few projects before that, even?
They were more like us just going in the lab and just freestyling on top of beats. The same thing we do now. Trying to kill each other on a mic, but now we do it with more structure.
Right. But that was, you know what? But that was then, we could do, these new people can't do what we did because we used to sell shit even if it wasn't our beats. They can't do that anymore.
Yeah.
Man, we had such a good time.
I still sell CDs out the trunk, man.
Always.
Yeah, but remember we used to be on beats that weren't ours?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. You still do that? I still sell CDs that got, yeah, hell yeah. I still got all that CDs that I did.
You just can't put them up nowhere?
Man, I just can't put them up. If I pull up somewhere, want some CDs, I'll be selling, man. I don't give a fuck about that shit, dog.
But that was like, dog, I always said like that was like the golden era of rap when we could be on those beats and still.
That was tight.
Man, cause you know, you, dude, come on, Hennessy and Cheetos.
All them thinking out loud, man.
Yeah. Yeah, right. You were doing the, that was like,
yeah, the whole mixtape game, bro.
All that shit, all that shit Stunna did, all that shit. That was all like other people's beats, but it was a way of getting it out there still back then.
It was like a way of showcasing like that I could rap. You know what I mean? On those type of beats, just trying to go as hard as I could.
Right. Even Chingo had a series called Thank God for Mixtapes.
Oh, no shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, you were on a lot of the Chingo stuff back then and the Eddie DeVille and all the, and we've talked about this before too, but you know, we just never got it on this kind of platform where we could talk about it, where it could stay and we could get a good thing. So I'm kind of glad we brought that up too. But you know, but you had a whole bunch of like, well shit, but well, first, if we go way back, there's Dope House, right? And there's Dope House Coast, right? Mm-hmm. Dope. You know what I'm saying? But man, shit, when later on when you link up with Eddie and them and you start doing that stuff, that's like, man, like, it's not Coast with the other dude and they're a duo. It's Coast alone. And, man, bro, you fucking blew us all away. Like, shit, this dude is fuck. Like, you fucking, like, you really, like, cemented who you are that, you know, maybe we weren't seeing it yet.
Right.
But you kind of, like, showed us, like, another. From everything, dog, from the fucking artwork to everything you would do was, like, this dude is not, he's on another level. Like, he's just an alien or some shit. Like, you know what I'm saying?
I mean, that's what I was going to bring up, the artwork.
With the Dope House stuff, you know what I'm saying? It was twin Berettas and the album cover was a pistol and it was just all like just straight gangster music. You know what I'm saying? It wasn't no deviating from that. You know what I'm saying? That was the image.
But
once I broke out of Dope House like that and started messing with Eddie and just being able to do whatever I felt like doing, that's when I was able to, you know, kind of spread out a little bit more and, you know, try different things, get on whatever, you know, just new types of topics, experiment with different types of genres, basically that whole kind of thing.
Got to be more yourself,
and
it, you know, and that, like, when we heard that version of you, of you being just being yourself, I mean, from everything, dog, you know what I'm saying, maybe not trying to be, but like some of the stuff you would do, like it would be like, even if it was silly, it was still player as hell, like it was, you feel me, like you never were like, you didn't give a fuck, you were just, you know what I'm saying, there was no, you know, no limits on the shit you was trying to do or say.
Anytime, and this is still the case today, whatever I do, whether it's experimental or whatever the case may be, I just want to make sure I don't come across as weak. You know what I'm saying? I still need it to sound hard, no matter what. Even if it's like the softest sounding song, I still want you to be like, oh, that's a soft song, but that bitch is hard.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
That's what I shoot for still.
Yeah, and then for sure, like, the deep shit has always stayed with us, too. Like, the deep shit is good shit.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I mean, you know, did you think, for instance, like, right, because, you know, Garza always had the, I mean, like, how I say this shit, like, Garza always had the, you know, the public eye on him. No matter whatever Garza was doing, there was always eyes on him. Right? You put out something right now. If you put out a video today, dog, that bitch is going to have, like, what? On average, how many people are going to look at it? Period.
Just videos, yeah, for sure. They're going to reach up to, like, 100, 300,000, 500,000, like, by the time we're done in about 3 to 6 months, for sure.
That's good.
Yeah, for sure.
That's good. There's niggas out here trying to get 1,000 views, like, trying to, I mean, that's a blessing. Like,
yeah,
that's,
bro, I appreciate that.
Dog, to have that kind of a crowd, and that's what I'm trying to say. Garza always had the notoriety. Right? Not that you didn't. You had a lot of notoriety yourself. But I don't think you, and this is just me speaking from a fan standpoint. So if I say anything that sounds like, yo, motherfucker, shut the fuck up, nigga, just say it. But look, what I'm saying is, like, but from a fan standpoint, like, you know, it always was like, you know, Coast don't care about that shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, we always felt that way.
And that's really the case. I never really looked at music as being something like for me to reach the stars type of shit. You know what I'm saying? It was always more of an outlet for me, because it's gonna be hard for you to find anybody else as introverted as I am. Like, I'm extremely secluded to myself, and making music is really my way of taking the things that I would normally internalize and just sit with and express them. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. That's how you get all those songs where I'm talking on deep subject matters about life and shit like that.
Right.
That's because really, that's just the type of things that float inside of my head at all times, and I just don't talk to people about it.
Right, right, right.
And so that you get thinking out loud 1 through 3.
So how about now? Like, now that you linked up with Garza, you know, and y'all got the Maquina thing going, y'all got this whole thing going. Obviously, you got other... We'll talk about more other artists. Obviously, we can't ignore Crystal. You got a lot of good things going right now. But, like, you know, now do you hope, like... Because Coast, man, we've... If your friend, if you have Coast on Instagram or something, anything, you know, Coast is constantly working on something. Like, are we now that you're with a more of a team that knows how to put it everything to the forefront the way they do? Is it like we're gonna hear all of it now?
Yeah. So what I like about being around this squad is they stay on me about, hey, we need this done. You have until this day to turn this thing in. You know what I'm saying? Where otherwise, I'm just like, I get around to it when I get around to it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But they actually push me in that sense. So, yeah, I already got an album ready to go.
You're right. And mm-hmm. that's good, because we need that. You know what I'm saying? Like, man, I enjoy all the albums. Yeah. I love that shit, bro.
Thank you, bro.
What did I tell you the other day, bro? The one that I thought was the dopest one y'all did. The one, Where I Need to Be, or was it Where I Need to Be with Slip on it?
Where I Belong.
Oh, yeah.
Where I Belong.
Yeah, yeah,
that was my favorite, dog.
Yeah. That's
I still jammed that hoe.
That's a good story.
It's a good song. Mm-hmm. You know? And yeah. So y'all always been good together. Mm-hmm. And anything y'all did together was always dope as fuck. And then Bunz, I always heard you a lot with just you and Garza.
Yeah, mostly.
On a lot of shit. Yeah,
yeah. This is the first album I ever done where I done music with Coast.
Yeah.
So this is
like... Also, prior to this, you never worked on them?
Yeah, besides like the Latin Mike Pass.
Yeah. But did you know Coast?
No. Damn.
But did you know of him?
Yes.
You always knew of him?
Yeah,
what'd you think about him? Like,
I knew
his
Coast
music
was dope. Yeah, I knew Coast was dope.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's always been dope.
He's decent.
You look at me like you look at that Maverick music poster.
Like that Maverick poster, man, nigga.
Man, fuck that dude.
I retract my previous statement, man. I retract my previous statement. Hell no, that nigga went dope. I know the fuck. Nah, for real though, I knew Coast was dope.
Yeah,
but I used to fuck with that boy T a lot. So he fucked with Lucky, and I already kind of knew Coach. You know what I mean?
Oh yeah,
so,
yeah. You knew of him.
Yeah, I knew of him, but right. I had never worked with him.
I mean,
before,
we all knew of him. Like there's,
yeah, exactly.
Like,
but
come on, there's no getting around it.
It's like I just knew of him. Like right. When we did the mic pass, I don't even think I met him then. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like we just were recording
on the same thing.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So
yeah.
I barely just, you know what? How you doing, Coast?
Good, bro.
How you doing, right?
It's nice to meet you, Coast.
Me too, so, man. Yeah. Yes, sir.
Because I really don't know
I'm
this.
I'm glad y'all met, nigga. Y'all got a whole album coming out. I'm glad y'all finally met, nigga. It's like an album coming out or something like that. From what I heard, nigga. You know what I'm saying?
Nah, but I like to rap with Coast. Coast got this other little flavor that I like to try to feed off of.
No, he's dope as fuck. And then when you're like, when you do a song with him, you're like, he did way better than me. Like you always think that. You know what I'm saying?
I
just paid this nigga to sound better than me and shit. You know what I'm saying? Like what kind of, that's gotta be the best rapper job. Like yo, I paid this nigga to sound better than me.
But I know I don't have to worry about no hooks. Now they just turn me
no more hook life.
All they do is just tell me just murk this verse.
Yeah, no more hooks.
I'm going straight in.
No, but that's the cool thing about working with these guys. Is before, you know, being around the Dope House or being around Chingo and all that, I was around rappers. Mm-hmm. But now I feel like I'm around MCs where technicalities come into play.
Before
I could just kind of hang back, and as long as I fit into the track, it was all good.
Now
I feel like with these gentlemen, I have to be competitive, which I love because I've never been tested like that before.
Right.
So when Garza say I smashed on Fuck With A Mexican or whatever track, to me that actually means something to me. It's like validation for me
because
I never had that before.
But you did a lot of albums with like with Stunna and Lucky. Did you ever feel that way with them? Like it was the same thing.
Working with Lucky is more of more along the same lines as just making sure I ride the beat that compliments him in a way that compliments him.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Because Lucky was never like the super lyrical. He was always the H-Town,
type
of vibe.
Right.
Stunna, on the other hand, he was more lyrical. But even then, he and I just had this relationship where anytime we got together, it never felt competitive like it does when I'm in a room with these gentlemen.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? When I get around them, I'm already like, okay, I got his number. I got his number. I'm going for their neck.
I got a mean face. I'm mean face.
You know what I'm saying?
What y'all want to do?
Was it? Do you think it was because it was new? Like, it kind of, you needed a new spark again?
Probably so.
Right? Like, you're so used to, right? You did. By then, by the last time y'all did, what was the last time project you did with Lucky? And I know you did the Timeless, right? That was the last one?
Yeah, the Timeless was the last one.
By then, you had worked with Lucky a million times.
Oh, yeah.
So, like, was it like you needed a new, a fresh new set of people to, like, a new breed of people to, like, work with next? Like, did it feel like that?
It's not that I needed it, but when I was approached by Garza to join the squad, it was enticing in that sense. And I felt like, that's something I never did before.
Right.
So I want to take a stab at it, see how I fall into the equation.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And what about, like, now, like, you know, you got Coast, you got Bunz, and then obviously we all know you got Crystal, right? Doing music and stuff like that. And she's like, you know, her shit is very, like, you could see it, her going up against, like, whoever's the pop hitting right now. She could go, she sounds like a Megan, like
dope.
Right? You know what I mean, right? Yeah, like, she has the sound of whatever's on the airwaves. She could do it. She could do that shit.
Bro, she can
better
rap.
Even.
She can rap with us. She can rap with Billboard charting artists.
Yeah,
there's
exactly.
Nothing she can't do.
Right, and I guess why I brought that up was, did you feel like, you know, when you locked in this girl artist and she's as dope as she is, and you know, right? And Bunz has always been a part of the crew. That's been your friend. That's beyond a rapper that you wanted on the click. He's homies, right?
Yeah, but did I've been down since day one.
Of course. So his spot was solidified, no matter what fuck, right? Just as long as he's ready to go, it's
exactly.
Going, right? But did you think like, man, if we could get Coast, was that ever a thought? If we can get Coast to be on the Maquina thing going, this will be like, this is what we need right now. Like, did you think that way?
No, because at first, I really didn't even think I was going to sign Crystal.
Yeah.
I met Crystal through Money Mike, opening up for us on our Halos and Horns tour.
Right.
And then when I seen what she could do on the mic and how she presented herself on stage, I knew she had it.
Yeah,
you know what
you
I'm
saw
saying?
It.
So from there, I was like, you know what? Y'all come back to the H. Let's work on some shit. Let's get some shit popping.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll keep this shit rocking and see how it go.
Right,
and
right,
it
right.
Went great. Phenomenal.
Yeah.
And then that's when I was like, okay, we got a tight little label running. And, you know, Bunz always been with me. Fellow always been with me.
Right.
And me and Coast always been seeing each other, man, for years. You know what I'm saying? And we've always saluted each other. Man, good to see you. Much love, da-da-da-da. So when I started thinking about MCs and people that I wanted to connect with, this was another guy that I was like, yo, I need this dude.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? There's things about this dude that it's like, as an MC, you a fan as well. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, of course.
So I knew I wanted to be a part of his journey.
Yeah.
And if it's something that I could do to help him, then I want to be down with that shit.
Yeah. What kind of, how did that conversation even take place though? Like, was there a conversation that came up where you were like kind of?
I took him to a strip club.
Nah. Couldn't say no to that.
Nah. It just happened. It was a lot of conversations.
Yeah.
It was definitely a lot of back and forth of like, you know, artistically, you know, I want you to do you.
Yeah.
I want you to be comfortable in your surroundings and, you know,
get
comfortable with everybody that's with us.
Yeah.
You know, make sure that you're making the music you like. And, you know, let's try to put out a couple mixtapes here and there and, you know, see how it goes.
Because I know, you know, Coast, you came from, like, a team kind of environment. So, like, you know what I'm saying? And then when you weren't in a team no more, you were, like, that's when you were, like, putting out the best shit you've ever did when you weren't with a team. So it was, like, getting with a team again kind of felt like a going backwards thing, or did it feel like a going forwards? You know what I'm saying? Like, does that make sense?
It makes sense, but nah, it ain't feel like that. Because, like he said, we used to always run into each other, like, out of town. And I tell you straight up, I don't like a lot of people.
Yeah.
But Garza, me and this dude just always clicked. Even though, like, yeah, we would run into each other out of town, we wouldn't go, like, hit up a spot together or nothing like that.
Mm-hmm.
We would just shake hands and be cordial.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? We'll swap CDs or something like that and just keep it moving. But always respecting each other in our craft. So fast forward to us starting to have these conversations about linking up. You know, all of that replays in my mind. Like, man, he always been cool with me. You know, he dapped me up every time I see him. Things like that, like he ain't never came at me wrong. So I was, you know, at first it was just like, okay, let me entertain what he's saying at least. But then it turned into just ideas starting to develop in my mind. Like, man, mm-hmm. if we got together and we started making these moves and coming out like this, man, it would be so hard. And he felt the same way. Mm-hmm. So I was like, man, let's do this, bro.
Yeah. And I mean, and how many cuts did y'all do on this one?
Right now we got 14. Before we dropped this tape, we had dropped the Platoon Season 1. So that's another, like, 15, 16. So we mm-hmm. we already got the chemistry there.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So yeah. we all know what we're going to bring to the table. All of us know what we are capable of doing. So I never have to question, like, they verses, they hooks, or what they finna bring. I already know if I send them something, it's crashed.
Right.
And then
right.
we just keep it moving. And then once we done finish record, we might record 20, 25 records. We just go listen to them and pick the best, you know, whatever we feel is the CD.
Yeah. And this isn't the first, this is not the first Brown Bionic, obviously, right?
No.
So how did it, like, why did y'all feel like y'all wanted to do another one of that? And just not name it something totally different?
I definitely wanted to close the series out. And there's a long history behind Brown Bionic.
Yeah.
I started it with Bunz, mm-hmm. and then me and Bunz had our situations, and then through that, we became a lot closer. I dropped part two while the time that me and him, you know, weren't seeing eye to eye,
right.
and kept it moving. And then the third time around, since we got with Coast, I felt like, you know what, we should close this out with a banger. I need mm-hmm. to bring my partner Bunz back into it, and then I want to introduce my homeboy Coast,
yeah.
and give it the Trinity. Right. All three of us together smashing the gas on you.
Right.
Mae Gunner's coming with it.
Mm-hmm. And that's how you, and what did you think, Bunz, like that? That was like y'all's thing originally, but now it's like here's another person coming into it. You were happy to see it that way?
Yeah. I was glad they kept Brown Bionic going. Brown Bionic was like, even the first one, like I didn't think it was going to take off as big as it was, and then mm-hmm. it turned out to be like more of a movement.
Right.
Yeah, then I had some personal issues I had to take care of, you know what I mean? And I had to step away from doing music.
Mm-hmm.
And just luckily, I was lucky that Coast was there to step in, you know what I mean? To keep going, to keep that in. Because there was, to me, if he would have done it with any other Mexican, I don't think it would have worked. Like, you know what I mean? Like, how I felt personally, you know what
Makes
I mean?
Sense.
So Coast go hard, so I'm glad they kept that shit jumping. For me to come back full circle, it's just a blessing. I'm glad the opportunity is still there. And always Garza has kept me, like, just active. Even when I wasn't active, he would have music of my shit in his computer and still releasing shit. Y'all thinking I'm still rapping. I was locked up, you know what I mean? Doing other shit, doing if I was...
He was keeping you alive regardless.
He was
regardless.
Keeping me alive, yeah. So that's why I'm always fucking with Garza. Like, I'm glad Coast is on the team. It makes everything kind of blend between us a little bit. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Like, because me and Garza are going to go at it regardless. I've been going at Garza since the day I met him.
Yeah.
Lyrically, you know what I mean? And Coast is kind of like that blend of a melodic type thing that he does that's just...
You know, and nice, you and know Coast, I mean? Man, and I don't even, and I know you never did it because you always rap the way you do and you've always made music the way you do. But did you ever notice that, like... Now the way like the pop culture, the pop rap is, the rappers that are the pop culture of rap right now, like they do what you've always done. Like the melodic shit, the late, like the fucking like deep shit. They do that shit now, nigga, but you was doing it forever.
He been ahead of his time.
Yeah.
No, and there was a point in time where I was like, y'all sons of bitches, y'all stole my shit. You know what I'm saying? There was a point in time where I thought like that, but now... I don't know. I still listen to it, and I think to myself, I wouldn't have did it that way.
Yeah.
I would have had a completely different approach to this song. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So they style is kind of similar or whatever, but they still not doing it like how I do it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That's how I look at it. That's how I keep from just getting angry about it.
And it's true. I mean, you know what I'm saying? You always did it a different way. But I was just saying, as far as like the way they try to do, you know how, even when you showed me the song you did, how you put so many layers in it? They do that now. Like, that's normal now. Like, motherfuckers do a song. It basically, like, you know, now if you can't sing, but you do sing, it's popular. You know what I'm saying? Not that you can't sing, but you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, no.
Like, that's the popularity. Like, oh, you can't sing, but do it anyway.
Yeah.
And that's just popping, right?
And it's almost comical to hear a lot of music that comes out now because, like you said, they can't sing, but they doing it anyways, but then they auto-tune and shit just enough to where it kind of sounds like it's right, but you can still tell it's way off. And I don't know why they put shit out like that, but... Hey, that's where music went.
Yeah.
So, okay.
But, you know, and I guess I was just saying, it was like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you were always right on track, nigga. Like, you was always right on track with the direction that everything, you always knew what the direction it should go, regardless of what the fuck. And you were doing it and didn't care what the fuck everybody else was doing anyway.
Yeah, I never looked at it like, man, 10, 15 years from now, everything is going to sound similar to this. I never looked at it like that. I never even looked at it like what I'm doing is just so completely different from what everybody else is doing.
Yeah.
I just would, like I said, I internalize so much that by the time I get into the studio and I'm ready to be creative, what comes out is just what comes out. I'm never approaching the microphone like, okay, I need a track that'll fall in line next to this person's song or that person's song. Or, man, I wish I had a song that sounded like that person's. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I never approach it like that.
And no matter what, how any of this shit goes, like, I mean, I just hope that you guys know, and I'm saying it to y'all right here in front of whoever watches this and for whatever, nigga. And I say it, even if y'all ain't around and we have our own hip-hop talk, the same shit I'm going to tell y'all. I mean, I hope that y'all know, regardless of how this goes, and I think it's going to go amazing. I'm going to manifest that for you. But I'm saying, I just want y'all to know is that, like, y'all have cult followings that are tremendous, and I hope y'all know that. You know what I'm saying? This coming from somebody that I love rap music. I loved it. I wanted so bad to be the guy, right? And maybe I gave up, or maybe I just something happened to me where I was just not with it anymore and just kind of stopped and whatever happened to me. But I'm saying is, like, the fact that y'all kept going, it was always good to see that these guys that I always was fans of or guys I've even worked with or to keep going, right? And it was like, to me, I was like, I hope they know how lucky they are that they have these cult followings, man. Like, you know, we always wanted that. That's all we ever dreamed of, was to have a fan base. And y'all guys have kept a fan base for, I mean, shit, man. Coast, you damn near disappear sometimes and you still got a fan base.
I don't know,
like,
how,
that's a
bro.
Blessing.
Who you, yeah, got, who you talking is. To, man? Like, I'm lucky as hell. Yeah,
this,
like,
nigga went to jail and
fuck?
Came home to an album.
Man,
like,
come
shit.
Come on, man.
Nigga, I'm if like, I went to jail, I'm nigga, I'm coming home to nothing.
Fan base. I'm the luckiest. Second chances really exist,
man,
you
bro. Know what?
I'm telling
the,
you.
But you know what? But gratitude is the best attitude, my nigga. So the fact that you think that way, there's
man,
more for you coming.
Thank you. For everybody who kept jamming me, thank you. You know what I mean? Like, straight up. Everybody from my hood kept me jumping. Garza Dang. Kept me jumping.
There you go.
People around the whole state of Texas kept me jumping. And yep. That's why they should get this album, because I'm going in on this hoe just to let everybody know how much
back.
I appreciate
there you go.
Staying. Fuck with a mask.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Man, you know.
Say one more of these, please.
Yeah. Yeah. The city loves it, man.
But you know what I'm saying, right, Garza? Like, I mean, the cult following is the cult. Dog, you don't have to be the, like, times done changed. You don't have to be on the radio and you can have the biggest crowd. You don't. Yeah. Dog, I remember, because we did a bunch of shows together when we were on our run with the Plead the Fifth. Remember, we used to do a lot of shows with Garza.
Yeah, yeah.
Dog, if Garza was rapping after us, yeah. Yo, he had that whole moving yeah. always. I was like, this nigga, they love this nigga.
Still
like, he, yeah, I know he's probably still, I haven't been a show in forever. But I'm
you
saying,
need to
but,
come, man.
But when I was doing them too, and if you were before me, after me, whatever, and you were, dog, Garza was always the same way. He showed up when he was about to go on stage.
Yep.
He wasn't there at all, nigga. When he walked through the door, he's going straight to, like, this nigga was always the same. Walk in, if you see him, he's going straight to the stage, or he's over there standing on the side because he's about to go on. This nigga got something to do.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And then get on, fucking rock the whole fucking place, get the whole place crunk, get off and walk out. Like, this nigga never chilled. It was like, I'm here to do this, I'm leaving when I'm done. That's
yeah,
it.
Man.
You know what I'm saying?
Show.
If you want to have a conversation with him, you got to follow him. Hey, Garza. You know what I'm saying? Like, this nigga,
right?
Yeah, this nigga got somewhere to be. I don't know where this nigga's going, but he got somewhere to be. It was always the same shit. You
as
know what I'm saying?
He's a celebrity, man. You can't just be so accessible all the time.
Nah,
you
know what I'm saying, nigga?
Nah,
that's why the nigga kept me on red, my nigga.
You
know what I'm saying? I was like, man, I don't expect anything different. I said, I don't expect nothing different from Garza, my nigga.
Nah, I just, you know, I go in and want to do my job the right way, man. That's all.
But you're always, but like, I guess, like, you were always so focused, nigga. Like,
definitely.
Yo, I'm here for that. That's it. Gone. Like, fuck
prime
it.
Prime time,
fuck
yeah.
the rest of this shit. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
you know what I'm
point.
Saying? And I know we booked a show one time, too, and I got, and Coast, I ended up getting you to come do it. I don't know if you remember this. We got together and we put together whatever we needed to do, and you were one of the artists that I wanted. I was like, yo, we gotta get close to do whatever. And then Snow came through too. Remember, this is before Snow was Snow.
Oh, was this at the
you
Private
Rec? No, it was at
Where was this?
No, nigga. Oh, no. It was at Zona.
At Zona.
Do you remember?
Yeah.
Thunder performed too.
Yeah, I remember.
With Clever, young Clever. Well, he was really young Clever then. Feel me?
Yep.
And you came and you did your set, but that was like, you know, whenever we were putting together the money and for the people we wanted to do what we wanted to do, you were the one that was like, "Yo, we got to get Coast." Yeah. Like that was like I pushed for that. Like get Coast, let's get Coast. Like whatever, and I would hit you up. How much do you think? And you know what I'm saying? I don't know if you remember that, but
no, I do.
We discussed it.
I do, yeah.
And then I was like, cool. Finally came up to whatever we came up to, and we had you come out and everything. And you know, and that's what I'm saying. Even you were the same way. Straight business. Come, do what you got to do.
Yeah.
Get the fuck out of there.
But like, that's what I'm saying, bro. I'm super introverted. You know what I mean? Like, I don't want to be around people.
I think the only reason why you even hung out a little bit longer that day was because a Stunner set was after you, so you just chilled with him for his set. And then left.
Garza was there that night too.
Garza was there that night.
I think he was. Maybe. No,
you were there.
I think he was actually just got done putting a new mixtape out, and I remember.
Oh, yeah.
I remember chopping it up with him about. He was telling me about his new tape or whatever.
You know, because even back then, dog, whenever we were back then, when we were setting up these concerts, it was like it was just my dream to like, you know, like if I can just set up all these shows with all the people that I think are the elites. And, like, it become the norm. Like, let it be these are the norm. Like, right? You know what I'm saying? And, you know, anything I ever did, I just wanted to see the Hispanic culture be, get its just due, yeah, man. Sure. That was always what I ever wanted. You know what I'm saying? I wanted for everybody to know, yo, fuck what y'all listen to. Coast is dope. GT Garza is dope. Stunner's dope. Lucky Luciano is dope. Bunz is dope. Like, come listen. Like, dog, stop worrying so much about what we look like and just listen to what we sound like. Like, these dudes are dope. Like, and I was like, man, these dudes have such big cult followings that they can tour without needing to fucking have anybody big on their shit or whatever. And I wanted everybody to see that then. That was like the goal back then. Because for me, I was like, I knew possibly I was getting to the point where there was a way out. I was going to get out. So then it was like, okay, if I'm going to get a way out the next round two of my life, I want it to be, let me help book shows or something. That was going to be round two, right? Obviously, I didn't stay with it so long. But then this was, and then in here, we're sitting here. This was round three. If I can put a spotlight on the culture and doing what I like to do, conversate, you know what I'm saying, whatever, then we will do that too.
Yeah, we'll
find a way to put a spotlight on the people that deserve a spotlight, you know what I'm saying? Because it doesn't always have to be, you know, we don't always have to be excluded. I mean, you know, I just wanted a way for us to have, you know, some, you know, I don't know, like a fucking spotlight, bro. Like,
nah, for sure, show, man. You gotta have an outlet and a platform, you know what I'm saying? For everybody to come up and, you know, tell you their story and their journey.
Right.
And where they come from. And everybody's story and journey is different. We all Mexicanos or Latin, but we all come from different places.
Right.
He from the north, I'm from the south. He from Twin Cities.
I'm from the country.
You know what I'm saying? So we all may, you know, our bloodlines. Our bloodlines may come from the same spot, but our stories are totally different.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. And you know, and then even then, right? Like you have your next chapter coming too, right? There's a reason why you picked up, why you wanted to do something with somebody like Crystal, someone young that you see has a lot of time left. I mean, did you think it's because you want to step away eventually?
I actually got into it because two reasons. Longevity and the same reason what I'm doing for these guys. If I'm able to use my platform to help somebody get to the next level, that's what I'm going to do.
Yeah.
Because I wish somebody would do that for me. Yeah. You know what I mean? So if it's something that I could do to help my partners or people that signed to me get their dreams across,
right?
Let's run it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because I'm going to be there right there with you.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So it becomes bigger than me.
Right.
And then it becomes more of like, all right, we're going to do this together.
Right.
And let's move as a unit. Let's make sure these people know who we are. And let's go out there and represent the people the right way.
But see, and then the fact that you think about it that way as you move is the reason why things aren't always going to go good for you.
Guards always been that way.
You know what I'm talking about?
He always been that way.
Yeah, always.
Always.
If I ever hit him up and needed a verse, he needed something, he always was down. Garza, he always came through. He always, man. You feel me? Like, he was never, you know what I'm saying? It wouldn't happen now. If I told the nigga come through now, you know what I'm saying?
Stop it, dog. God damn.
You're going to have to go through me. I need a 10%.
Hey, yo, hit him. Hey, I can see it now. Hey, yo, hit on Mike.
Need 10%. Where money Mike at? Yo, money.
Money need 10%.
Money. Hey, yo, hit on Mike. My nigga, he'll let you know.
I'm co-manager now, so I need a 3%. Hey,
I'm busy right now, my nigga, but hit on Mike. I'm
just kidding. Nah, but for sure, man.
But you know what I'm saying. Like, you were always, you know, whatever it was, you were always with it. You were always, dog, you were always, you know, ready to help in any way. You know, or to, you know, shit, you didn't even, fuck. You didn't even know. I could have been the fucking worst rapper in the whole world, but you still did the song.
I mean, dog, at the end of the day, we all got dreams. You know what I'm saying? And who am I to knock somebody's dream?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So if it's something that you want to do, hey, man, sometimes it just takes time and consistency. Sometimes it takes, nobody's going to hop on a basketball court and be Jordan the first day.
That's true.
You know what I'm saying? That's so true. Your crossover going to get better. You know what I'm saying? Your dribble, your dunk, you know, defense going to get better. So the more you hit the booth, the more you work at this rap shit, the better you're going to get.
Yeah. Dog, and you don't age at all, my nigga. Do people tell you that?
Oh, nah, bro.
Garza, you look like Garza. Like, yo, my nigga.
Hey, what a camera.
What do you eat, nigga?
It's 2021. Nigga?
He's a vampire. Yeah,
this nigga don't age, right?
I'm 15 years old right now.
I'm telling you, man. Say, this nigga's drinking blood. This nigga grows backwards, bro. I'm
this
telling
nigga
you,
don't
man.
Age, bro. Say, you know what I'm saying?
He got them good genes.
Yo, man, I don't know, nigga, but this nigga, you know what I'm saying? Even when I saw you when you pulled up, nigga, you look exactly
like Benjamin Button. Say, nigga.
Yeah, right. Going backwards and shit. Yeah, I'm telling you.
Next time y'all see me, I'm gonna be a baby.
Hey, they just gonna sit you on the stage.
Spin shit.
Go.
Spin shit.
The boy's gonna pull me out of the stroller.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
I'm gonna push him in.
Yo, you look at his baby going on.
Fuck with a Mexican baby. This gig right there. I'm gonna push him in.
Fuck with a Mexican baby.
Man, I got this fuck with a Mexican baby. He's killing shit.
Wait,
killing
that nigga.
Babies. Killing all babies.
It's your turn.
Spot.
Wake up, nigga.
I'm about to change my pen before I do a show. I can't do a show. I need to
get 86 years old already. Man, 86. Give him a cigar.
Hey,
like
dog.
Baby on Roger Rabbit.
Hey, man, but you know what? But even though, since the album is Brown by Honor, and you know what I'm saying? Man, if I could fucking have a whole conversation with Garza alone. I could have a whole conversation with Coast alone. I could have a conversation with you alone. You know what I'm saying? So I tried to, like, spread the conversation as much as I could here. You know what I'm saying? Which is hard, right? Because I could talk to you, like I said, I could talk to you forever by yourself. You forever by yourself. You forever by yourself. You know what I'm saying? But typically when people come on our show, we don't just interview like, oh, you're a rapper, you're this, and we just fucking, you know what I'm saying? We get into, like, just conversation about anything. So we decided to talk about just some shit, right? So we were thinking about talking about, like, you know, like being immigrants, like coming from immigrant families, lineages, things like that. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, and see where the conversation goes from us talking about that, right? Because, I mean, you know, we all come. I don't know y'all's backgrounds, right? Me personally, my dad, my mom, you know what I'm saying? They, you know, Mexicans didn't have nothing, you know, fucking worked their ass off to have something. And, you know, just that, I guess, like, that hunger and that, the different lifestyle it is to come from an immigrant family, right? A lot of people don't know. Some people don't know what that's like. Some people do.
I think that's what unites all of us, man. Everybody's story is like that.
Yeah.
Coming from nobody, parents struggling, having nothing.
Mm-hmm.
You know, going like, when the lights go out in my house, I ain't afraid. I ain't going to hang myself. You know what I mean? I know what I'm going to do. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I think all Hispanics come from some sort of background of struggle, hustle.
Yeah,
know what it's
but
like
it ain't
to get
even just Hispanics, bro. You gotta think.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
About
all,
like, let's say
immigrants.
Like Asian immigrants that come
all
to this country,
that,
they set up shop,
right.
And then they got their first generation
you're
kids.
Right.
They put them through school, like
right.
All type
right.
of different immigration, or I would say races, come to this country because they believe in what in the dream, the American dream.
Right.
You know, it's a possible over here to make it and become somebody, or just, you know, feed your family.
Right.
So I think we all go through that same shit.
What is y'all's like for instance, like we know you're popular, right? We're your age. We were around you doing the same thing. We've always been around entertainment somehow, right? What does your family think? Like, the knowing you've done what you've done, do they even know, or are they just like, oh, that nigga raps, or that nigga likes making music, or do they know? Like,
you
wanna
answer that first?
Me?
Cool. All of y'all. Coast. Does your family know your Coast? Does your family know your GT Garza, nigga? Does your, like?
Hell yeah, they be always trying to.
They don't know what that shit means.
Every time a quinceañera pops up, they want me to be at that.
Hey, yo,
man.
Yo, Garz, the man before.
I tell my mama, look.
I'll just fuck
yo, don't worry about the GTs coming through.
Man.
That nigga don't even know.
My hood knows me, yeah. Man. Everybody.
Bro, I tell my mama I'm finna go do a show. She said, bet, go take that trash out first. Shit, I don't give a fuck who you is. Go take that trash out, bro. And give me $20 for some cigarettes or something. She don't give
a shit. Is that really what it's like?
Man, what?
Well, Coach, what about you?
They love it, you know what I mean?
Does your family know, like, I did all this?
Well, yeah. So, my family is, like, just full of musicians, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So, I guess now, because of the internet and stuff like that, they have something to reference and gauge where I'm at in my popularity or whatever.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, they could be like, oh, well, he's accomplished this, that, and the other. Mm-hmm. To whereas, you know, other family members before the internet came about, it was just like stories passed around, you know what I'm saying? It's not something they could visually look at and be like, he did that.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So they're able to witness what I'm doing.
Right.
You know what I mean? And they understand.
Right. I get that too, because I remember if I would tell my mom 10 years ago, yo, check me out, I'm on YouTube, she'd be like, what the fuck is that? Yeah. But now I go to her house, and she's like, yo, let me put on some music, and she goes to the YouTube to put it, and I'm like, how the fuck does my mom know, nigga? What the fuck? Like,
they be getting on Facebook, my mama got a Facebook, my dad got a Facebook.
Did she add you?
Man,
yo, y'all, you don't add your mama in.
Y'all don't
shit,
better. Y'all better not try to follow my mama. Don't. Y'all better not.
Tell, that's rule number one.
Don't accept your mom?
Don't accept your mother.
Why?
No, because all she's going to do, every time you post, she's going to hit you up with some.
Why you say that?
Some advice.
You all right?
You can't act the fool. You can't act the fool.
Back in the day, pictures or something.
Yeah. Put a baby picture up.
My mother's cool, though, but I'm like, sometimes I feel weird when I'm on Instagram smoking a sweet and my grandma likes it. You know what I mean? It's kind of weird. You know,
yeah, it's kind of weird.
She never accepted her.
Yeah. What did you tell her? Garza told me to do it.
blame.
I need to stop hanging out with Garza. But I mean, shit, it's just shit like that, dog. Like, how far we've come along, right? Like, I'm telling you, 10 years ago, my mom didn't know shit about YouTube.
Yeah, now I
go to her crib, and then when she's like, I'm going to play music, I'm thinking, like, she's going to go put the radio. But nah, nigga, she searches songs she wants to hear on YouTube. Like, oh, let me find it. Even if it's fucking old shit, Bronco, nigga, on the fucking YouTube, nigga. And I'm like, damn, bro, like, my mom is using YouTube.
My kids love it.
Dog.
My kids love my music. They said that they be singing Garza verses all day long, sending me pictures. They love our songs.
Nightmares in my kitchen.
Everything. All kind of words. I be having that. It's the only time they can say cuss words when they singing my verse.
That's
the only time it's allowed. It's when you getting me crunk when you reciting my verses.
But shit, man, I mean, we just come such a long way, you know what I'm saying? Like, as far as, like, you know, like I said, man, my mom and dad didn't have nothing, and I've heard their stories of everything they had to do to get to something, and I'm like, damn, man, like, the average nigga couldn't live through the shit my dad tells me, dog. Like, I'm like, fuck, it sounds like a movie almost. Like, how the fuck did you do that, bro?
Facts.
You know what I'm saying? To coming to, you know, doing everything he did, to building everything he did, to just having a successful life here, when before all he had was whatever he had on, that's it.
Yeah, bro, that makes you who you are today.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? The sweat that they put in, you know what I'm saying, to make the load lighter for you.
Right. But do you think, like, the more the time goes by, the less the generations coming know, or the less they have respect for what had happened already, right? Do you know what I'm saying?
That's just fading away.
Yeah. Like, they don't know.
You have to teach that, man. That's not something that is just going to, it's going to fade away if you don't teach it to your children. You don't teach the hard work, teach the struggles, teach what it's like.
Yeah.
It's just going to fade away by generation.
It's that's why it's important to know the stories, right? Like, your family stories, and tell them to your own kids, and tell them to your own, right? So that way they know, like, hey, we weren't always here. If
your
wasn't
ancestors and your ancestors. Yeah. Keep your pictures, man. Show your family. Show your kids where you come from, who the hard work that brought you to where you come from. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, it's disrespectful not to do that. You know what I mean? Like, straight up.
I'm with you. It, like, you know what I'm saying? The only way any of the thing stays alive is, it's like when somebody passes away, man. The only way they ever stay alive is if we keep on talking about them.
Yeah, exactly.
But if we stop talking about them, they get forgotten.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
Up.
It's like, that's how you live forever, is through the people that love you.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Your memories.
My government name is my grandfather's name. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Your and grandfather's name GT?
Nah, it's not on. That'd be dope. Nah.
Right?
Nah, yo, GT. It's Renato Tomas Garza. Yeah.
Okay.
And I told my gal, if we ain't naming my kid that, I don't want no kids with you. You ain't having my baby. Hey, man, I need my grandfather's name in there, baby.
If you don't at least name that nigga GT.
Hey, he ain't coming out. It better be a girl.
If this nigga ain't named GT.
And it's going to be like Henarita or something. It's going to be somewhere in there. It's going to be something.
Nah, Bunz, dog. The world ain't even going to be right if your son ain't named Bunz, my nigga. Is he? What's his? Nah, bro, don't tell me. Don't break my heart right now.
No. It's not.
What's that nigga name, bro?
Man, my son's name is Jagger Music.
No, bro.
Jagger Music. I got Sabbath Legend and Kiss Slim, man. That's
my boy got rock and roll names.
Jagger, Sabbath, and Kiss. Those are my kids. You know what I mean? They rock. Tight. We rock out. You know what I mean?
Dude, God bless you,
Jagger,
bro.
Jagger, come out here.
So what if that nigga was named Bunz?
Hey, man, and if you meet my son Jagger or any one of my kids.
They cool, man.
They cool. They'll break the mic right now.
But if you have another kid, you going to name him Bunz?
I ain't having no more kids.
Yeah, but if you did... In another word. No more kids. Said, don't put that in the atmosphere, nigga.
Like, damn, bro.
Don't put that on me, nigga.
No, there's only one.
Coast, please name if you ever have a kid, Coast, bro.
Would I name Coast?
Yeah.
Yeah, probably. Yeah. It's kind of fly.
That's a government name.
It's kind
of fly. Man, I'm just saying, bro.
That's a cool middle name.
Coast.
Coast?
Right. Yeah.
Yeah.
I can rock it down. That'd be cool.
Yeah. Yeah, hey, I could do that as a middle name. I could do that.
You know what I mean?
Henario Coast.
Get the hell out of here.
I could do that, bro.
Did you ever, remember, because you were Coast, when we knew you for so long, it was Coast in the beginning, and then you put Cassette Coast. Right. Did you have to do that to separate, for people could be like, you know, so it could be like different? Because Coast was so like, Coast is, right?
No, I had to do it because people would tell me they can't find me online. Every time they go to Google Coast, they'll get results that show like Galveston,
the shore,
shit like that. You know what I'm saying?
Beautiful coastlines.
Yeah. It would never pull up
the
my
Bahamas.
Music.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So I was like, well, shit, I might have to change this up somehow, but I just didn't want to deviate too far from my name. So I was like, well, I'll just add on to it then.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But why'd you go with Cassette? Because there was no more cassettes in play when you remember Cassette Coast.
So when I first started like trying to be a rapper or whatever, I was in high school and I would just rap on my little karaoke machine, and I would record it on cassette tapes. I would buy like multi-packs of blank cassettes at the Walgreens, and I would just spend all night dubbing them over and over and
over.
Damn,
man.
And
the
then
same
I would go
shit.
Up to I'd go up to the high school, man, and I'd be out in the parking lot just trying to sell my tapes for $5, $2, whatever.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Just trying to sell it to people.
Yeah.
And so when it came time for me to like, I felt like I needed to change or add on to my name. I said, you know what? I'm going to add something that actually has meaning to me.
Mm-hmm.
And the way I started was selling cassettes.
Yeah.
So I'm going to just throw that on to my name, Cassette Coast.
Right.
Yeah.
And the crazy thing is, right, is like, as far as like, when you finally were had a legit album, you never really had a cassette out, though.
Never.
Yeah, but you were making cassettes in the hustle.
Cool. Yeah.
Blade, you
cool
know, right?
Fuck.
Remember we make the cassettes,
that
nigga?
Cool.
Where is
fuck
he at?
Right?
We used to make the cassettes. Me and Blade used to do the same shit. That's why when you said that, dog, we used to make cassettes all night so we could sell them hoes at school and
that's
shit.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Everybody did that.
Yeah.
Man,
man.
I went to MacArthur and I had you tape.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Tell us, bro.
Audie Melrose.
So he can vouch.
Tell us the school.
He can vouch.
I know about the tapes, but when I heard him say Cassette Coast, I already knew it has to do, you know, because the tape was out there. It was in rotation. Everybody talked about it. It's everywhere.
Braze is from the Melrose.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, man. The fastest day one too. You know what I'm saying? I used to be out there just trying to do my thing. You know what I mean? A lot of people would be like, you know, get out of my face with that bullshit. And a lot of people was like, you just want a dollar, bro? Here's a dollar. You know what I'm saying? But to me, it felt like something.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Because I was actually out there moving and shaking.
Yeah.
Getting my what did it say? Getting your feet wet or whatever.
Yeah.
So.
Or shit, making a whole, because like, you know, if you, to put that, see, dog, if you did it through a tape and you had to do the entire song live, because it wasn't like you had a, you know how now it's like you up, you gotta do the verse over, do the, nigga.
You gotta do the verses, you gotta do the hook three times.
Straight through.
Yeah. Straight through.
If you fuck up, you start over the whole song.
We started it over.
Damn.
It just gonna make that noise. A drink. You gotta keep
start
gotta
over. Right back off. You would get mad at that nigga. If there was a second verse, it was another nigga. Get nigga, you
skip that song. Skip that song.
You knew that whole by heart, nigga. You don't even have to use the paper no more, nigga, because you done said this whole about 800 times. It didn't even matter. You were like, man, I know this bitch by heart, nigga. Front, back, hooks, fucking everything. Man, I remember that shit getting mad at niggas, bro.
Hey, but that experience, though, being out there selling my tapes in a school parking lot, that's how people knew that I rapped, and that's how I made my first connection with somebody that was like, hey, we gonna go record at a studio. You rap? Why don't you come with us? And so I went with him, and I got in the studio, and I was... For the first time, I'm 17 years old, and I'm recording in an actual studio. And from there, it snowballed into meeting this person and that person. And then the next thing you know, I'm at Dope House. And the next thing you know, I'm with Eddie and Chingo. And the next thing you know, I'm with Garza. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, yeah.
It's like you were always at the right place at the right time. Mm-hmm. Right? I mean, how does that, right? Because, come on, you keep it real. Like, you when you getting into Dope House is already like, come on, bro.
Yeah, they already had the universal deal.
Like, nigga, like, this is the Mexican rapper of Houston. Like, nigga, everyone knows about it. Whether you like him or you hate him or you whatever, he is who he is. Mm-hmm. Right? So how do you feel being who you are, doing what you did, and then, like, you're having this opportunity? Like, how does that feel for you
At that time, I was super excited. And I'm still happy about it to this day.
Of course.
You know what I mean? Because it launched everything that came after. You know what I'm saying? But, yeah, man, back at the time... Just for them to approach me with a contract was like, are you serious? Mm. Like, it's so many people out in this city.
Yeah.
You know, and we right by downtown, and I'm looking up at these big-ass skyscrapers, and I'm like, man, there's people in them offices that don't want to be there. They want to make music. You know what I'm saying? And shit, man, I'm fucking 19 years old, and they offering me this contract? For real? It felt like the blessing that it was.
Damn, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I felt it. And with everything in my body, I felt that.
Right, because, I mean, anybody else, like us, we're rapping in the game, like, you know, shit, we would Eternal even, right? Eternal came across Stop Our Mexican a lot in the beginning of his career as well. You know what I'm saying? When you were Latin Embassy, right? You would have did anything to be on that label.
Oh, yeah. We would have did. Trying to get out of
see? We would have did anything to get a sign, like at least get us on a verse, something. Right. Garza probably thought the same way when he first started, like, if I could just get on a Dope House song. Right? You probably been on one now since.
Well, back then, bro, I'm not even gonna lie to you. I never was on that side. Like, I never really heard SPM or none of that. Like,
what were you? What
we
was
were
your...
jamming Lil Kiki and DJ Screw.
Southwest shit.
So I didn't really, I'm gonna tell you like this. I was late to SPM. I didn't, my first pit time of hearing SPM for real, was Time Is Money.
Time Is Money.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I ain't know nothing about that. You know what I'm saying? Until then. Yeah. And then I had to go do my research and catch up. And, you know, then, you know, we did records together and stuff like that.
And that was late.
Yeah, you
that
know what I mean?
Later,
so
yeah.
I would just...
That's already Universal.
Hustle Town Jam.
Yeah, bro.
So, all that shit was dope.
Yeah, I was super late to the party.
But you knew about Most Hated and all that, though?
Nah.
Not
none
even?
Of none of that. None of that, bro.
Damn.
None of that. I'm from Fountain of West Airport.
My introduction to Hispanic being a rapper, even when I was young, was probably Most Hated. My introduction. Well, Cypress Hill, but like, I'm saying Houston.
Nah,
locally.
Locally.
Yeah, probably.
Most Hated. The white label.
That, might have been some,
that was my first.
Me too.
Which
jammed
one?
They
Most
jammed
Hated?
Too. Yeah, Most Hated with Jam. I used to go to their concerts and shit like that.
Yeah.
And Jam, and they used to have that stage rocking
and
shit.
Hell
like
yeah.
That. Yeah, I've been to a few of their shows when I was younger.
So that was my first introduction to it, like a Hispanic doing it. Like I said, be real
that came
first.
Later.
But,
that came later. Yeah.
Yeah, but Most Hated was the first. Like, I was like, damn. This is crazy. Like, these Hispanics are doing their thing. It was, like, at a car show or something, and I was just like, damn.
Yeah, car shows.
That's wild.
These dudes are doing something. Yeah. What about you? What was your first?
I'm going to say, I'm a little older, so, you know, Houston-wise or all the way-wise?
No, Houston-wise.
Oh, Houston-wise, it was Most Hated. But I jammed out to Cypress Hill and...
Definitely Cypress
Hill. Big Pun, you know. Then I had heard the Kid Frost back in the day.
Yeah. Oh, my dad put me up on Kid Frost. He was staying in, like, Roma, Texas, bro. Somewhere that so small.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But he was jamming Kid Frost.
Kid Frost.
You know what I mean? So that was one of the first, like, Latin MCs I really heard.
What about you, Coach? Was the first Latin MC you ever heard, really?
It was probably, like, Aggravated before they became the Most Hated.
Aggravated, definitely.
Yeah. And then... when I heard the Most Hated album and I heard SPM on it, Actually, before I even heard the album, I was at a Los Magnificos car show at a little, I was a little kid, you know what I'm saying? And they would perform, Most Hated was performing, and Carlos got up there and did his verse that he had on that one song. And I was like, oh shit, that dude is hard.
Yeah.
And,
what was it, that Warriors?
Yeah, Warriors.
Yeah.
And what's crazy is after they finished performing, they had a booth set up. And I went over there to the booth, and I bought a SPM poster.
Yeah.
And Carlos signed it. He wrote my name on it. He signed it for me. And I took it home, and I had it up on the wall.
Yeah.
And at this time, I'm like, I don't know, maybe 13 years old. Never did I think, fast forward another 5-6 years, I was going to be part of the squad with him. You know what I mean? Yeah,
manifestations, so that was, bro. Manifestations. Yeah. I was the same way, dog. I tell Filero on them all the time when I run into them. Like, dog, I had the white label one, and like I met them at the car show, and they were all there, so they all signed like by their. And I had it on my wall for years.
Yeah.
The old Most Hated and shit, and like, you know, and later on I talked to them, friends with them, whatever, you know, shoot shit with them, whatever. And I'm like, man. You know what I'm saying? You just manifest shit sometimes, nigga. Like, you know what I'm saying? My whole room was full of rappers. You thought I lived in fucking Sound Goody or some shit, nigga. You know what I'm talking about? Like, I was like, I had everybody. DMX, fucking all this shit, you know? That's why, like, somebody like DMX just passed away. Rest in peace, DMX. Like, dog, that shit, like, dog, that's like, it broke my heart, nigga. DMX raised me, nigga. Like, feel me? Like, right? You know, like, dog, DMX dying fucked me up. Like, and that's what I'm saying. It's like, you know, these are people that, man, come on, bro.
You grew up on, man.
Yeah, bro, shit, come on.
He used to talk about my life, you know what I mean? Like, straight up.
Dog. You know,
him and Tupac, they used to talk about
Pac
my life.
Them, no,
bro.
There's a lot of better lyrical artists besides them, but I'm saying, like, they, those artists weren't saying shit that I was going through. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But DMX and Tupac was...
Yeah, DMX was very real, you know, real about shit.
A lot of shit.
You know, a lot of shit. Very honest. Yeah. Very honest. I think that's why we always liked, you know, the coast your shit, dog, because you were very honest. Like, you were very vulnerable, dog. Like, very, like, open. Yeah. About what the fuck you was going through, whatever you was going through, we could sense it. Like, this nigga means this shit. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you could tell.
Yeah, and like I said, it wasn't never like I'm aiming to shoot in that direction. You know what I'm saying? To me, being creative is just like releasing a valve for me. Like, otherwise, I just have things just bottled up until it'll drive me crazy. So music, I'm releasing that valve so I can let it out. It's not for no particular group of people to listen to. It's not for a specific demographic I'm trying to capture.
I feel that.
It's just so I don't go crazy.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Right. So you don't bottle it all up.
Right.
Yeah.
I feel that.
You know, what about you, Garza? I mean, did you think you let a lot of deep shit out throughout music throughout the years?
Definitely. It's the same with Coast. I think music is the way to vent. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? To help you keep sane and shit like that. Certain things you know, I think we all probably, you know, had jobs and went through things that we was, like, decent at. And the one thing that just caught my, you know, attention and my mind frame was music and hip-hop.
Right.
And I just stuck with that. You know what I mean?
Hey, but is that your way of, like saying, like, so niggas, like, know, like, that you really ain't gonna do it? Like, hey, hit up Mike. I bet you Mike's phone blowing up and he ignore everybody.
Mike be tired. Are we on camera right now? Are we on camera right? Mike tired of my ass.
You know Mike does.
Money
like,
done with me.
Another idiot. I ain't gonna entertain these niggas.
Money the only nigga. We can't fire each other.
He probably hates his phone. That nigga probably tried to chunk this hole.
Me and Bunz seen him sleep in the car. He was like, Bunz was like, what you doing to this dude, bro? You overworking this man, bro.
Stressing him out.
That's my brother, dog.
He got about 90 titles. He got about 90
titles. Yeah, dog, he do, man. He be getting the job done, though.
Everything, hey, Money Mike, everything Garza doesn't want to do. That's
everything.
The title.
Man, everything I can't even handle.
I ain't got to do everything I don't want to do now, too.
Nah, look. Yeah,
everything niggas don't want to do.
I'm going to tell you the one thing about Money, dog. He has a trait that I can never have. He's a people person. He's very
He's
sociable.
He's always been, though, man.
He's very sociable.
Even back then, he was always at
he
all the
He know how
stuff.
To talk to
he
people.
Was,
he don't ever let his feelings jump in the way of, you know, that's not his first thing. He gonna think about something first before he just jump to it. Other people like myself, we might just go off our emotion.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So he the smarter one out of me and him. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like,
and then, you know, and that's how when I met Mike, he was just a friend in the crew that was always at everything y'all were doing.
Yeah,
because at that time, we were always performing at all the same places. So I knew Mike through.
But he keeps me level-headed. You know what I'm saying? He makes sure that I don't say the dumb shit. You know what I'm saying?
And so it is good to see that he's still, you know what I'm saying? Because I knew he was around you. That's 10 years ago, nigga.
I'd have cursed everybody out already.
That was 10 years ago and the nigga's still around.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
For sure.
That's a relationship that you definitely took care of, man. It looks
man,
like,
yeah, that's my dog.
Well, shit.
Shit, they closer than you think, man. We did the Brown by Honor.
Yeah.
And they family live on the same damn block in Laredo. You know what I mean?
Oh, like, we went all the way. So check this out.
Yeah, damn right. His grandma and, like, Money's people live on the same fucking block.
So I met Money in 2006 through V-Zilla. And Money, them boys was shining in the club. And, you know, you rapping, you coming up. I'm in the underground. I ain't got no jewelry. And them boys was looking like they was doing it.
Yeah.
So I was like, man, I wanna know this dude.
Yeah.
And, you know, he knew my partner, V-Zilla, so we got introduced, you know. Yeah, and then, you know, our relationship grew.
Right.
Man, I probably know Money for like a decade after that.
Yeah.
And then we went to Laredo one time. He's like, man, my family stay in Laredo. I was like, oh, mine too. So we jump in the whip. We go. I pull up on my grandma's house. He's like, bro. Man, my family stay on the same street, but like two blocks that way. Not same street, like this way, that way, that way. Literally, like, look down that way.
Yeah.
That's their house.
No
and
shit.
And I was like, what? Man, bro. So me, Cap G, Money, we all shot the video in Laredo, went out there and, you know, barbecued at his uncle's crib, everything. You know what I'm saying?
That's
small
crazy.
World, bro.
Yeah.
Crazy.
Never knew.
Never.
Shit, man.
You know what I'm saying? Laredo ain't small, bro. Laredo big.
Yeah.
It's real big, bro.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
How is it now when you go out there, though? Like, you're just like, nigga, you like.
I went to school out there.
I know, but how is it when you go perform now where you're at now?
Oh, man, we have a
like,
ball out there.
You shut shit down out there?
Yeah, bro, because, like, you know, people know that I stay out there. You know, I rock. I still got a lot of homies out there. I got family out there. You know what I'm saying? Border towns always show us love because we definitely put on for the people, bro. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. We won with the people.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So they love that shit.
Yes.
And we love that shit.
But it doesn't feel like it's like that in the city, though, right? Like, in the city, it's harder.
Nah, not necessarily. Because in the city, I feel like right now, I'm respected by the people that I used to jam. I used to look up to these guys.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Now I'm respected by the same people that went gold and platinum, and I ain't never been gold or platinum.
Yeah.
You know
true.
What I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, I don't feel like that at all.
Right. That's good, dog. That's good. You know
for
what I'm
sure,
saying?
For sure, for
because, shit, you can go anywhere, and it's good for y'all right now.
Definitely,
that's
definitely.
For sure.
I got a question real quick. Coach, who do you jam to, or is it instrumentals that gets you into picking up the pen and getting the booth and riding, doing your thing?
Man, honestly, I don't listen to no artists to inspire me to pick up the pen. Honestly, bro, we sitting right here, bro.
Before you start riding, like, whoa. You know, is it a
Nah, go ahead. For.
Or is it a, you know,
Nah, well, I listen to a lot of, like, obscure artists, right? Like, so a lot of times with artists, like, you can hear who their influences are. Like, they'll, especially with rappers, like, they'll kind of sound like their favorite rapper. They'll try to, like, steal their style, their patterns and shit like that. The type of music I listen to, bro, is just so obscure. Even if I started telling you names of artists, you'll be like, huh? What type of music is that even? You know what I'm saying? So, but even then, like, the music that I listen to, bro, it's not nothing that inspires me to start getting in the studio and approach a song a certain way. You know what I mean? Everything is already pre-programmed in, like, in the soul, basically. You know what I mean? Like, so I can't tell you I pull this shit from anybody in particular.
Yeah.
It's just the way I do music.
Yeah, it comes natural.
Yeah.
You got your like producers that you like, they're your go-tos though?
Yeah. So, and especially right now, right? So in the past, I've always worked with the people that I've developed relationships with along my journey, you know, from Dope House and so on and so forth, and including my brother Slip. To this day, me and him still work on music together. But now, the next thing coming up for me is going to be the solo album, Beautiful Monsters, right? So
right.
Beautiful Monsters is not only the title of the album, but it's also the name of the production group that is producing 100% of the project.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, I mean, that's really right now, that's who I'm getting everything as far as my personal music goes. But as far as everything that I'm doing with Brown by Honor or just, you know, whatever La Maquina shit comes across my plate, you know what I mean? We got a select few that we always reach out to. Yeah. They're our go-tos, you know what I'm saying? Who we got? Like 357, we got Cap.
Cap on the beat, track sounds, Risco
Funk. You still
get
beats from Risky?
Yeah, Risco Funk, Tim Ned. Yeah. Definitely, man, Risco. We got a gang of producers.
Lazy be submitting a lot of
man, shout out Risky DJ Lazy. Beats forever.
That's my brother, man.
Forever.
Hey, man, he made some of my best jams, man.
He did a lot of the beats on Crystal shit, right?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah,
he been rocking with us for decades, man.
He did some good beats, dog.
Bro, he's elevated his game to the top notch. Like, he even did my last record with, damn, who was that? We did Professor X. We did Off the Edge. Man, I got so many records that we did Roses. We got classics, dog. Yeah. You know what I mean? Risky is a fool with it.
Dope.
Shout out to my brother Risky.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Risco Funk. Yeah, man. So y'all keep certain people that y'all are always that know y'all.
But it's not even because we just have this long relationship with people. It's because they actually dope.
Oh yeah, of course.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Hell yeah. It's not like anybody doing anybody a favor.
Yeah.
It's like, man, we fucking with you because you just on some whole other level type shit.
Yeah. So if Risky was trash, you'd be like, fuck this.
Nah, yeah. But see, that's the thing. Like, Risky, Risky, friend.
You know what I mean?
He still be our friend.
He don't have to hit a mic to get in.
But Risco's dope, though. So there's a whole different level. Every time I go to Risco's studio, he always makes me better. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like, even just as a producer.
Yeah.
And in the most subtle ways. Just this tone or pause right here or just the smallest things, you know what I mean? And it sounds like that. That's what I love about Risco.
He's a good producer. Not just beat making, nigga. He's a good producer. Phenomenal.
He used to make the most basic beats for me and I used to rap over them. Then I come back the next week, he had all kind of shit behind my shit, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
He's super dope with that. Yeah, he's dope.
That's tight, man. Shout out to Risky, man. I ain't seen him in a while.
Yes, sir.
But shit. All right, man. Well, before we get out of here, man, you know what I'm saying? First of all, I appreciate y'all for coming through, man, and doing this shit with us. You know what I'm saying? We're honored to have had y'all come talk to us. Y'all could have talked to anybody. Y'all did talk to a lot of people before us, but we're not going to talk about that.
That's called scheduling. That's just scheduling.
But you still came.
We're on a promo run. Nah, we got you, bro.
But, you know what I'm saying? We do appreciate everything, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, before we let y'all get out of here, you know what I'm saying, give you all you guys a chance individually to, you know, send some shout outs, do whatever y'all needed to say, you know, to whatever y'all want to say to anyone who is going to listen to this. So go ahead, Bunz, what you got?
Oh man, you know, just shout out to everybody. Fuck with a Mexican, y'all know what it is. All the hard workers, everybody starting from the bottom, everybody coming up, fuck with us, man. That's how we do it. And follow me on my social media pages. Bunz 1000.
There you go. Instagram, Bunz 1000.
You know what it is. Follow us. Fuck with a Mexican. GTGarza.com. You know how we do it.
Yeah, I'm going to follow you. I'm going to send you a DM. Don't ignore me, nigga. Garza ignores niggas, bro.
I'm going to read it.
So I can get in. Hey, you're doing a show, nigga. I'm going to hit you. Hey, nigga, remember that time, nigga? Nah, nigga, come on, bro. I was there. You was there, remember? Me, nigga. Get me in, bro. Garza don't answer. Yo, Garza, what you got?
Man, I want to shout out to the squad, La Maquina, you know, the whole crew. Shout out, you know, my dog, Coast, Bunz, Risco, Fellow, KP. You know, Money Mike, Rob G, Charles Chavez, everybody that's, you know, helping us get to where we need to get to, you know, putting the plays together. You know, we're having a great time right now. If you like, you know, the music we've been making, you definitely gonna like the new music we finna drop. Make sure and scoop up Fuck with a Mexican. Look out for Brown Bond the 3. Beautiful Monsters, Nine Lives, Crystal Popping new shit. Man, we're gonna hit y'all with a wave of shit, man, and we not gonna stop.
Dope. What you got, Coast?
Man, I just wanna say thank you to Garza. I want to say thank you to y'all three gentlemen. I want to say thank you to Krim's Crib because at the beginning of this interview, y'all introduced me to this man, Bunz. That was your name, right, Bunz?
Yes, sir.
I had never met Bunz before this interview started.
Like Bunz 1000, if you want to follow him on Instagram.
Just remember that.
Yeah.
If you need to follow him on Instagram, niggas, Bunz 1000.
If anybody want to follow me on Instagram, I'm at Cassette Coast on all the social media, YouTube, everything like that. Yeah.
Man, we appreciate all y'all's talent, everything y'all are doing, and the fact that y'all keep on going. It's beautiful to see that you know, there's still, you know, Hispanics at such an elite level still going, still. Man, it's, dog, that's all we ever wanted was to have people keep going. That's all that mattered to us, that somebody
man,
was doing
that.
It, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
that it's still going, that it doesn't end. Like, it's still going, it's, and it's getting bigger, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. It's getting bigger. It's just getting bigger. You know what I'm saying? So, shit, man. Just y'all just keep doing what y'all are doing, and fuck, man. We'll keep on watching and keep on wishing the best for y'all.
And the goal is to inspire people to keep it going after us. You know what I'm saying?
Facts.
Like, you know, if anybody could pick up the baton from us, shit, grab that thing, man. Go with it.
Who do you think somebody that is picking up the baton?
I have no idea, but I hope somebody does.
What about Clever?
Clever is one of them.
Everybody got a shot, bro. This is a Wild Wild West right now.
Yeah, but what do you think? How do you feel about what he's doing though?
I've always been a fan of Clever since he was since he was a minor. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, dope.
Yeah, he's dope.
I just did a record with
him. Really dope.
I don't know when it's coming out, but I just did. Yeah, Clever's dope, man.
Fuck yeah, really dope. You know, I just wanted to throw him in there.
And all that shit's tight.
Yeah. That nigga gave me a hat. You know what I'm saying?
Oh yeah.
Yo, that nigga gave me a hat, bro. You know what I'm talking about?
So, we ain't come with no merch.
Guess what you can get for a shirt.
Thank you, Clever, for that hat, nigga.
What size is this? Man, yo.
I just bought 3 people.
Yo, that nigga said, yo, what hat you got on?
For sure, though, man. We appreciate you, man.
I ain't never gonna get a fucking hat, nigga.
Nah, where money at?
Yeah, nigga.
Merch man.
He's on again, nigga. Disappear, boy. Magic man.
He said, let me get the fuck out of here before this nigga asked me for my hat. My shirt. Anyways, nigga, you know what I'm saying? Man, appreciate y'all niggas for coming through, man.
Always.
Shit, man. I love the music. I'm such a big fan of everybody here. You know what I'm saying? And, dog, you know, just keep doing what you're doing. And until then, till next time y'all got something else. I would love to do one just individually too, because I got so much to, you know, I had to spread around the way I was trying to talk to everybody, but I like, there's so much that I could have a whole, I've had a whole conversation with Coast before, you know what I'm saying? But I would love to have one, you know, like this, where we recorded all, I got the cameras now.
Yeah,
everything.
I'm with it, bro.
You know what I'm saying? Whenever you can. Garza, I'll talk to Mike, see if I can make that happen.
Man, this is it, bro.
You know what I'm saying, dog?
I gotta bring like 4 sweaters, 3 hats, 2 jumpers, just to get in the building.
La Maquina fucking winter fucking.
Man, you better buy them for me. You better take them pictures. Yeah, I'm gonna tell you, I'm gonna take a photo shoot. He going to everything.
Yo, that nigga's gonna come through with the fucking, you know where you hang up the clothes, that thing? Mm-hmm. Full of shirts.
Damn right, he's gonna come with the whole
closet rack. I'm bringing the tattoo man and everything. We're gonna stamp it on you, everything.
Shirts ain't even your size.
I'm Maquina, I ain't never gonna leave you. We're gonna stamp it on you.
I'm just kidding, baby. Bunz, man, shit, dog. Man, fucking with y'all niggas, man. Fuck with these Mexicans, man. Yeah, goddamn,
definitely.
Krims, Krims.
Fuck with the Mexicans.
You know what I'm saying? Really fuck with us.
Appreciate y'all, man.
Always. Yes, sir. You know what it is.
Shout out to Blade for letting us use this fire.
Blaze World, thank Blaze World for letting us be here.
Let us use the spot.
If you need a haircut, nigga, come fuck with Blade, nigga. You know what I'm saying?
Shout out to La Maquina, Bunz, GT, Coach, y'all legends. I love the music.
Yes.
I appreciate everything y'all did for the culture, for us.
And we still doing
motivating us, making us proud of who we are. Man, you know what I'm saying? It's love.
We're going to go hard. Man, we gonna rap. You know what I mean?
Man, so and we know you are. And we know you are. We know you are. Eternal, you got something to say before we go? What?
Just salute to these boys, man. Love to see what y'all building. All the shit, man. Y'all keep going. Keep pushing the culture, man.
Yes, sir, man. And shit, I know. Hey, when that was the whole purpose of when we did the fucking the when I told J-Vaz to do that top 10. That was just because I wanted to fucking light on the fucking Mexicans, bro. On the Mexicans in the culture. Like, fuck, dog. Keep Why not, nigga? Nobody else was gonna do it. That's why I did it. So anybody who got upset, I was like, fuck y'all. Y'all don't do it.
Keep pushing it, bro.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I wanna see people get bigger. Y'all
don't
care.
What you believe in,
y'all
man.
Too busy fighting with each other, nigga. I'm trying to see everybody do it.
Man, we all trying to win, man. We all trying to get to the top. You know what I'm saying? Man. Feed our families and make some shake. You know what I'm saying? So let's get busy.
Thank you. Appreciate y'all, man. Good energy. You know what I'm saying? It's good being around you guys and everything. And you know, shit, man. You know, anytime.
By the end of this year, I'm gonna be on that list, though.
Definitely.
You deserve to be.
Just watch it.
Yeah, definitely.
Bro. Man, I'm gonna talk to Mike about getting you on that list.
Listen. That's all we
need. Hit up Mike. And if y'all don't like it, hit up Mike at Mike 713. I don't know that nigga shit. I'm just kidding, man. All right, niggas, get the fuck out of here. Later.
Yeah, I'm straight from the jacks. Back- back at your neck. Do what I want cause I earn my respect. I came to collect, hang with a certain select. I doubt we could ever connect, been coming correct. I'm who you need to elect, can't trip like I'm losing the step. You know what I rep, soon as I push on the trunk, get open with special effects. I'm with the coolest, cooling by the border. Smoking that Gary Payton by the quarter. Keeping that greenage around me like a hoarder. I got the Kelly Clarkson for the snorters. Watching for scissors coming from the cold. We're sleeping on me just means you in a coma. Waving my soldier red like in the know ya. This is forever, I'ma take it over. I'm a La Maquina official member. My home made of ice from the coldest winter. I got people that owe me, I don't remember. Bigger fish in the sea that I gotta simmer. I'm on that 187, what you expected? That's who I am, they gon' say I'm respected. Highly connected, fully invested. This what you get when you fuck with a mask. This what you get when you fuck with a mask. That's who I am, they gon' say I'm respected. Say what I want, what the fuck you expected? What you get when you fuck with
a
mask.
You know who it is, get you a fix. Country messing, coming straight out the sticks. Count it up and then I weigh out the bricks. Let them move them, I just stay out the mix. I'm in them whips, rolling them splits. Jamming that screw from 1996. Gold on my wrist and my crucifix. Rolling with your bitch or who I choose to pick. I'm never question, look at me flex. So you need a plug, I'm the connection. I see a thug in my reflection. You in the cut, I'm the infection. We got that girl that's ready for the water. I lose a point, two on a quarter. I can handle anything that you order. Just put the tunnel underneath the border. I'm a La Maquina representer. At the table, I ain't eating dinner. Run a 40 on, I'm like a fucking sprinter. I got diamonds on me all up in the center. You better show some respect when you come to my section. Watch what you say to me, use some discretion. You smell exotic, come from my direction. I don't think you wanna fuck with this mask. Yeah, Bunz.
This what you get when you fuck with a mask. That's who I am, they gon' say I'm respected. Say what I want, what the fuck you expected? This what you get when you fuck with a man.
Mind of a hero, robbing the wrist to supply my amigos. Independent living, highly illegal. Dividend spending, I'm fly on the free throw. Tico with a Tico for the people. Break it down and divide up the kilo. Anybody wanna ride on a speedboat? Middle of the night, a moonlight on a D-Lo. Mijo, we gon' catch a wave and activate a pass and play. My man's a fake and cast away. With that exchange, we'll grab the paper, crack the safe, get back to base, and we can allocate it. Having faith in me is a show shot. Nobody gotta know about where the dope drop. I'm a roadblock to a whole cop. Coast got no problem. Involving a Coca-Cola, bolas big and brown. I come tipping down, a slap drop till it hit the ground. My fifth was found, I'm out from my bitch's house. It's fucked up, oh well, get a different style. I'm sipping crown, my arm hang out when I'm flexing. Cadillac car take off like a Jetson. Rather drink ball, but it causes indigestion. The fuck you expect when you're fucking with a mask?
This what you get when you fuck with a mask. That's who I am, they gon' say I'm respected.